Greetings and welcome to this session. We are going to look at relation between stagnation temperature and Mach number. Now, in case of aircraft air cooling system, we have seen this equation before. Relation between stagnation temperature T2 and atmospheric temperature and velocity of aircraft. So if you consider this equation, here temperature T1 and T2 are in Kelvin, then velocity is in meter per second and CP value is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Now suppose in the numerical, instead of this type of data, suppose Mach number is given. Instead of giving velocity of aircraft or velocity of air, Mach number is given. So how to find temperature T2 in that case? That we are going to study in this derivation. So what is Mach number? Mach number is an important parameter in the analysis of compressible fluid flow. And the Mach number, it has been named after Austrian physicist Ernst Mach. It is a ratio of, I'll write down the equation over here, Mach number M, it is denoted by M, it is a ratio of actual speed of fluid or object in still fluid to the speed of sound in the same fluid at same state. So V bar is velocity of aircraft, or you can say velocity of air. Okay, now here there are two considerations. If you consider the practical scenario, aircraft is moving in this direction, air is suppose still. So V bar will be velocity of aircraft. If you are looking at the wind tunnel, in wind tunnel, aircraft is stationary and wind flows over the aircraft. So in that case, we will consider velocity of air. So it depends, okay? So V bar is velocity of aircraft or velocity of air, whereas C is sonic velocity. Or acoustic velocity. So M is called Mach number. So if M is given in the question and we want to find T2, how to find that? We need some equation for that. So that equation which we are going to derive with this derivation. So we will start with this equation. Okay, we will divide on both the sides with T1. So I'll write down the equation. So dividing both the sides by temperature T1. So here I'll divide by T1. So what I can get over here, T2 by T1 is equal to 1 plus V bar square upon 2000 CP into T1. Now, what is CP minus CV relation? This you have studied in your thermodynamics. So, we will do a small rough work over here. CP minus CV is R, characteristic gas constant. Take CP common. So, CP in bracket you will have 1 minus CV upon CP equal to R. Okay, now CP by CV is gamma, adiabatic index. So CP by CV is gamma. So what I can write, CP इन ब्रैकेट 1 माइनस दिस इज CV by CP, so it will be 1 by gamma. 1 by gamma equal to R. So CP in bracket gamma minus 1 upon gamma is equal to R. So what I can get over here, CP is equal to gamma R upon gamma minus 1. So substitute the value of CP in this equation. So I'll write down. So I have substituted the value of CP as gamma R upon gamma minus 1. Now next we will see the equation of velocity of sound. So velocity of sound C is equal to under root gamma RT, where C is in meter per second, gamma is adiabatic index, R is characteristic gas constant. Here unit of R is joule per kg Kelvin. Now remember that in this derivation, whatever R we are using, here the unit of R is kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, but for this equation, unit of R is joule per kg Kelvin. So we need to take care of that. Then T is temperature of medium in which sound travels in Kelvin. Okay, now here you can observe we have gamma R T. Okay, but this R is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin and this R is in joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so we will take this 1000 over here. So I'll write down the equation now. T2 by T1 is equal to 1 plus velocity square gamma minus 1 upon 2 into gamma into R into 1000 into T1. So this gamma RT is what? It will be C square, velocity of sound square. So I can write down T2 upon T1 is equal to 1 plus V bar square gamma minus 1 upon 2 into C square. Now what is V upon C? It is Mach number. So that term will be M square. V square upon C square will be M square. So T2 upon T1 is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 upon 2 into M square. This equation you have to remember. And this will be equal to T2I upon T1. So what is the use of this equation? If Mach number is given, if the aircraft is moving in air, so gamma is known, gamma is 1.4 for air, and atmospheric temperature is known, T1, so we can find stagnation temperature T2, which is equal to T2I.